He's able to fix any situation. And there's nothing too hard for him. He's the creator. He's the all-knowing God. The Bible declares him as being omnipotent, meaning that he has all power in his hand. He's omnipresent. That means that God is everywhere. The Bible declares him as being omniscient. And that word omniscient means that he is all-knowing. My God, I feel the anointing in this place. Who wouldn't serve a God that knows everything? Oh, and the Bible says a fool has said in his heart that there is no God. And so when you know the truth, how many know that the Bible says in John 8, 31, 32, Jesus said, if you continue in my word, and that's one of our mottos for this ministry. If you continue in my word, that means there's an action, a verb, there's something that you have to actually do. Then you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. And so it's vital that we continue. That's the base scripture that the Lord gave me for this ministry, Wholeness Empowerment Ministries. He said, there are many of my people are walking in a form of godliness and denying the power thereof. Many of my people have begun to hew out cisterns, to hew out cisterns, reservoirs, ways and patterns to manufacture or to manifest themselves and what they see the word of God is saying. And so what he means by not that, he means that the lifestyle that they're participating in, that they're living in, they have hewn out and built their own pattern and way of doing things which is outside of my word. And so because of that, it brings on a form of godliness. And it makes the individual deny the power of God to do what it needs to do. And so I know the word of God is powerful. The Bible says it's powerful, it's quick, it's sharper than any two-edged sword. And so if I cut you with a sword, what you gonna do? Bleed. And so because God made us free moral agents, he given us the ability to choose, the word of God is quick and it's sharp. And it can pierce, it's very precise. That's what sharp means. How many know that because God made us a free born angel, he don't make us receive him. Amen. He don't make us obey his word. He gives us the choice. He said, choose ye this day who you're going to serve. Amen. And so if we're going to serve God, then we better be in the basic instruction before leaving earth, which is the Bible. Amen. Now I'm going to say that again. And so if we're going to choose God, we better be in the basic instructions before leaving earth. Because there are many that because they have a form of godliness and they've set their own pattern and way for serving God, there are many that will be left behind, it's sad to say. And so I'm excited about God. I'm excited about his spirit. I'm excited about his anointing. And I want to say, when in my teaching, I'm always practical in what I do. And that word practical means hands-on. This thing is going to be so simple to that one-year-old over there can understand what the Spirit of God is saying. When God speaks to his people, it's never beyond our ability to understand what he's trying to say to us. And so he said, if we, being evil, if we know how to give good things to our children, how much more will he give us the ability and the power to understand what he said? He said, to as many as received me, to them gave he the power to become the sons of God. And so in order for you to be molded and shaped and become the son of God that God called you to be, you have to receive the power of God. That means, like we went through praise and worship in all the songs that we were declaring. We were declaring, Lord, I'll wait for you. You're the sun in my horizon. I know, Lord, there's darkness without you. And so, and Lord, I receive you. So we declare with our mouth that which we desire. Why? The Bible styles us as living epistles read of men. And so if we're going to be the epistles of God, we have to say what God say until we see what we say. We got to be dogmatic with a militant attitude as to, I'm going after the things of God. I want to say that sometimes we get a little, I don't know if it's because from Sunday to Sunday is 7 days. And most people feel that's a long time. I know in this ministry, in this church, we do Monday prayer at 7. And then we do a time in the Word at 6 on the Blog Talk Radio. And so sometime between Tuesday and Thursday and Friday night, we forget as to who we are. And so the Lord had called me when we started this church. The first way he called us to start, we started in the book of Romans. And so everything we do from the next few Sundays in our Sunday teaching, I mean teaching is different on Mondays or whatever, we're in the book of Romans. And so the book of Romans, it speaks about mastering self. How many know that you got to master yourself? We're in basic training. I believe last Sunday we talked about basic training. We talked about going into the armed forces and going into as a, when you go in, when you first go into the basic training in the army, you go in as a what? We got an army brat here. You're going as a private. You're enlisted. You go in first and you go through basic training as a private. And so there are various things, there's strenuous activities and doings that you have to go through. And I believe you have to pass the test before you go to the next level, I'm sure, right? So in the things of God, sometimes in the body of Christ, we forget the basics. We forget the foundation that Jesus Christ is the foundation of our very lives. And so we make this Christian lifestyle as though it's something so hard for us to live. I can't live that. I can't do that. I can't do that. Because this thing is so hard. But how many know that Jesus said the way of the Lord to hard to a transgressor? Yeah. Jesus said, my yoke, that means what I put around your neck, is easy. And my burden is light. Why is the yoke of Jesus easy and his burden is light? Because not only did he save you, he sanctified me. He set you apart for his use. But he gave you the power to be who you are. I talked about that big white truck out there. If I don't put gas in it, it's not going to have the power to run. Amen? And so I can end up on the side of the road at any time. I think it's on E right now.
Amen.
We went to Walmart last night.
Amen.
And it is on E right now. The big white goose is on E. And so if I don't give it the gas, the power that it needs, we gonna be walking, ain't we, baby? So he probably ain't gonna get in there with me or send me to the gas station by myself. I hate to stop to the gas station. Isn't that big old truck takes so much gas? What is it? But anyway, so we need the power. God wants to change our focus and our mentality when it comes down to Christendom and the lifestyle that we live. We need to see Jesus in everything we do. We need to see that our ability is not enough. Our capability, it makes us null and void in the things of God. You know why? Because the Bible says, in you dwell no good things. There's no righteousness in us. So God is not looking for our capability, but he's looking for our availability. Am I available to do what the words say so I can get what the words say? Amen? And so I'm just going to briefly review from last